Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Power Platform TV. Today, we're going to take a look at preferred solutions. So I love this new feature because, you know, when you create an object in the PowerApps Maker portal and you don't put it into a solution, you just forget to do it, right? So let's say you create a new table and then you go back to the table and you realize it has that new underscore publisher prefix, right? Because you forgot to put it into a solution, okay? So Microsoft has fixed this problem for us, so that never has to happen again. We're gonna see here how to set that up, and it's really easy. Basically, an admin just has to turn on a setting, and then any user can go into their Maker portal and then set the default publisher solution. Okay, so they set the solution, and then the publisher prefix will be inherited. So let's go and take a look here. And this is the Microsoft documentation, by the way. So it's a preview now, and it is set the preferred solution. And let's jump into how to do it, and then we'll come back to this, and we'll take a look at some of the restrictions, okay? So here I am in the Power Platform Admin Center. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to go over to Environments, and I'm going to click on one of my orgs here, and then go to Settings. And if you expand product and go into features, okay, we're going to see down here, we're going to scroll down a little bit here, and we can see here, if we keep going, preferred solution, right? Let me just go up a little bit. So when on, Dataverse will automatically add any new or updated objects to the user's preferred solution when the user is not in the context of a solution, right? So that means if you're not in a solution, you create a new object, this is going to help us out, okay? So I'm going to turn this on, and of course, when you turn on these features, don't forget to come all the way down to the bottom right here and click Save. And this is just instant. So this is now going to be rolled out to all the users, right? So this has been saved, and what we can do now is head over to Power Apps here, and here I am in the make.powerapps.com portal. And you can see here, you know, before I refresh this page, the solutions here is, you know, it's just listing a couple of solutions. And if I go ahead and refresh this, let's take a look. And you could see here now we have set your preferred solution. Okay, great. Now, the current preferred solution is this one, the Common Data Services default solution, right? And what I'm going to do, let's create a new solution here. I'm going to call it, let's call it my solution. And here we set the publisher. And actually, I don't have a publisher for myself here. So let's go ahead and create a publisher as well. And I'm going to go with this. I'm going to use my name here. The prefix is going to be my name here as well. And you can see this is what the object names are going to look like. Okay, so Kyle underscore object. Okay, so I'm going to click Save here. And so now I have a solution, and you know, I could have many solutions here. Obviously, in a typical environment, you're probably going to have a ton of these solutions. So I'm going to click, I'm going to go back here and click new solution again. Let's call it my solution. And now I can set the publisher prefix to the one that I just created, and I'm going to click create here. And so we have this, we have the solution created. Now we got to tell the system that this is the one that we're going to use as the preferred solution. Okay, so it's taking me into my solution. That's okay. Let's jump out of this. And now I'm going to click manage here. Okay, and then this is where I get to select it. And I'm going to select my solution down here. I'm going to click apply. And you know, that's kind of it, right? So now I'm done. So let's take a look at actually seeing this in action now. Okay, so let's say I go up to tables here and I go and create a new table. So I'm going to click create new table, and I'm going to do add columns and data. Okay. And, you know, they just make this interface so nice these days. I'm just going to let's call this my new table. Let's say my new table, and I'm going to click save here. And straight away, you can see it's already picked this up, right? It's already picked up the schema name with the publisher prefix. So I'm going to click Save. I'm going to click Create. And, you know, remember, I'm not in a solution now, right? But it automatically knows that that's the prefix that it's going to use because it's inheriting it from the preferred solution, right? So if I go over to properties here, you know, you'll see over here as well, it has the prefix set. That's awesome. And now let's go back over to solutions. And, you know, you can see here it says preferred solution for my solution here. And if I click into it, we'll see that my object will actually appear in here now. Okay. Sometimes you have to hit F5 just to refresh it. I've noticed, you know, you may add it and then it doesn't appear the first time. But let's take a look here and see. It's going to. Here we go. And so if we expand tables here, so it's automatically created, added it to the solution, right? You know, so this is basically your preferred solution, your default solution, maybe, if you want to think of it that way. But, you know, everything is going to end up in there now. And that by everything, I mean, you know, there are some restrictions. So if we head back over here to this post over here about the from the documentation, we can scroll down a little bit, and you know, please keep in mind it is a preview feature. You know, so we'll get it rolled out into a general release at some point. And you know, this kind of talks through the setting up the solution, and here are the limitations here. Okay, so it says you can't set or view the preferred solution in the classic Solution Explorer. Okay. You should be trying to not use the classic Explorer as much as you can. I know it's hard for some people to pry off it, but you know, the new Maker portal is just so nice. So just use that one. Components that are created in the classic Solution Explorer won't go into the preferred solution. Okay, same kind of thing there. Preferred solution currently doesn't work with the following. Okay, so cards, data flows, AI builder, chatbots, flows, connections, gateways, custom connectors, and canvas apps created from image or a Figma design, right? And who knows, you know, over time they'll probably upgrade these so that they also inherit the preferred solution as well. But you know, that's kind of the functionality there. I think it's something that's so simple, and you know, I don't see a lot of talk out there about this at the moment, but I think it's kind of a little bit of a game changer. You know, if you're a dev and you're building apps all the time and you make these mistakes where you build things outside of a solution and then you're like, oh no. So, you know, I think this is a nice one. I really like what the product group has done here in adding this one. It's helping us on a daily basis, right? You know, so they're looking out for us, okay? So that's all I have, and hope you guys enjoyed and hope you guys get to use this feature.
So that's it, guys. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and of course, check out my blog at carldesouza.com. Thank you.